Hello friends, welcome once again to Obapa's Recipe. Today's video, you're going to learn how to make authentic Ghanaian kenke or gat kenke. This is my favorite kenke recipe that I want to share with you and your loved ones, friends. So please don't go anywhere, sit down and let's start cooking. Alrighty, so to get started, you need corn husk. So this one is normally called a bro janye ehunu. Yes, and that is what we need. That is part of the ingredients. And next, we need fermented cornmeal. In chi, we also have a bro a ye jan. Na ye di egun sum na ye mre. Na ya yam, na ya fiti. Ye di e siwo ama e muade e punu. This is fermented corn. That is how we need it. And next, we need our salt to taste. Okay. All right, friends. So next, we're going to soak this corn husk in the water. All right. So before we soak this corn husk in the water, I'm going to wash it first because that's what I usually do. I don't know how long this has been sitting in the store. And it came all the way also from Mexico. So I'll just prefer to wash it first before I soak in the water. So just go ahead and then wash it really nice and very well. So this way it will wash away any bacteria, you know, any chemicals used to, you know, keep it alive. It will just take it all off. That is very important. And I'm using warm water to wash it. Yeah, so that way also it helps a lot. And after we wash it, just leave it in the water. So next, I have here my corn dough or my fermented corn, and I'm using my measuring cup, and that is what I'm gonna use. So I'm not making a lot, I'm just making for me and my family. So actually, to begin, we need only, you know, 3 cups, but if you're making it for like a big family, you can add about 6 cups, and that should be enough for about 10 family. So next, I added my salt, followed by the water, and I have my wooden stick on the side. Yeah, that is what I'm gonna use to do the stirring parts. Yeah, for this kenke. And friends, with this wooden stick, you can get some from any African market near you. They sell this everywhere, okay? So right now, we're gonna get our stove ready. I just turn it on into a low medium heat. And gradually, we're gonna stir this up until it forms like a dough. So friends, please make sure that you keep stirring this. The moment that you leave it down and you don't stir, this will burn easily, especially if you're cooking on this kind of pot. So make sure that you keep stirring until, you know, the consistency will gradually change. Okay, as you can tell right now, it is forming like bangkun, and we're not gonna cook it all the way through. So basically, we're gonna cook it like a halfway. Yeah. So just keep stirring, make sure that you don't get any lumps in it. That is very, very important, friends. Yes, and I think in a very nice pa, I'm gonna say a monster by a soft. That is how I usually like my kenke. So I usually cook for about 15 minutes and I'm gonna cover and have it cook for extra 15 minutes and then I'll come back and check. Alright friends, so it has been 15 minutes so far and I'm just gonna keep stirring it. It's halfway cooked, not completely, and this is perfect. So right now I'm gonna get my bowl ready and we're gonna start adding up the other one. So I have here the remaining corn dough or corn meal. So this is the remaining ones and I'm adding about 3 cups of corn meal. So you have to add the fresh one and the cooked one together. That is what basically this recipe is. I was said uti sa emolini bi egun chain. No wati mankuno awa kanu suka kra egun chain. Awa di ayde odi afra. So right now everything is ready and it's hot. So I have to let it cool down before I mix them up. All right, friends. So it has cooled and this is perfect to mix them up. This is the normal way of making kenke. This is so good. Trust me, if you try this recipe, you will never be disappointed. I really love kenke, and I know that most of Ghanaian, we love kenke. I don't know about other countries or the other cultures, but we love kenke. Yeah, so it's already mixed. It's looking really nice. So What I like to do is that I like to, you know, form it like in a little ball shape. It's a hanobuko swa toso na wire day, wabo bono, kokrowa kama. So the usipeni bia. If you want to do it like in a bigger size, you can. It depends on your choice. But I like my kinky a little bit, you know, small, because that way it cook faster than, you know, making it like bigger. Okay, yeah, but it's your choice, it's up to you. You can do whatever you want to do with this kinky, it's up to you. Okay, friends, yeah, you can just do it. Yeah, I'm so happy that I'm trying this recipe because I am craving for kinky for a long time, and I know that wherever you are, this is gonna be a really good recipe that actually you can make. You don't have to buy kinky again, trust me. After you make this recipe, that is how it is, friends. So I'm almost done. All right, so this side you're just gonna let the fun part begin. So just go ahead and wrap it up with the corn husk. Okay, just feel free, follow the procedure that I'm doing and wrap it up. You know, it's similar like you're making tortilla, like how the Mexican do. I don't know if I got it right. Is it tortilla or something like that? Yeah, that's how I think that they make it, like, you know, a little similar like this one, but a little bit different, you know. But they use corn husk very much in their recipes as well. So just, friends, go ahead and wrap it up with the husk and just follow what I'm doing. It is so easy, stress-free, you know. Just go ahead and make your kinky. It tastes fresh as well, because there is nothing better than your own homemade. Just here. Homemade in the wawo ya a kaman kasa wawo nimiya wadi ayde ayo dhiyane. That is very, very important. So keep repeating until everything is done. And one thing I like about kinky also, you can eat with anything. You know, you can eat it with okra soup, okra stew, hot pepper, fried fish, you know, chicken. This recipe is just amazing, you know, and it fills you up. Trust me, this will fill your hunger. You're not gonna get any hungry anymore after you eat this. And also, you drink a lot of water after you eat this kinky. Okay, that's my experience though. I don't know about you, friends, but that is how I usually do. Yeah, so friends, everything is nicely done. As you can tell, we have formed it in a very beautiful, authentic shape. That is what we want, okay? So the next part, we're gonna get our stove ready again, and I have my pot ready, and I'm using medium heat, and that's what we're gonna use to cook this kinky. But before I add my kinky, I like to, you know, add extra husk in there. All right, so this way it keep your kinky from burning. That is very, very important. And my dog honey in the end shit into the kakari the egu asie na so the baby basic your kinky no na end shit and something in the end pacha and yemi mremre. That is how you want it. So after you add your corn husk, just go ahead and add your kinky in there gradually. Make sure that you place it in the right way. You know, everything looks very nice and neat. That's how we want it. We don't want a messy recipe, okay? All right, so next I'm gonna keep adding extra corn husk on top just to cover it. Normally in Ghana, I think they use like a plastic cover or something like that, you know, to cover it up, but I'm using the same husk, you know, to cover it. And I'm adding my water, so I'm gonna fill it up like all the way, not so full. I don't want it to, you know, boil all over my stove and make everything messy. So I just fill it up like in the medium way. So you're gonna cover and have it cook for about 3 hours. Okay, friends, so it has been about 2 good hours, and as you can tell, the kinky has boiled into perfection. It is so soft, like how I want it, but it is so hot also. So you have to be very careful when you use it. So I'm just gonna cover it back and have it cook extra about 1 hour, and then it should be ready. Not just the kunaide have been. So as you can tell, our kinky is ready. It is looking nice, so delicious. It's about to go down. Yes, serve it with anything. Shito, hot pepper, okra stew, okra soup. Just enjoy the beauty of your hard work. Thank you so much for watching, friends. If you really like this recipe, please share with your friends and loved ones. And please don't forget to hit the like. And if you have any question, feel free and ask. Thank you so much for watching and also cooking with me until I come your way. Stay safe, stay joyful, and have a blessed day. Bye-bye.